Hello, viewer. My name is Michelle Tetu from Lockwood Girls High School in Form 2. Welcome to the Science Hub, and these are my colleagues.
Tiffany McKenna.
Michelle Gabon.
Today, we'll be discussing about respiration. As we all know, respiration is a process whereby food substances are chemically broken down into energy. First, it's broken down into energy, and it's also known as ATP. ATP is known as adenosine triphosphate. It's also broken down into carbon 4 oxide and water. Respiration can also be known as internal respiration. My other colleague will go into the significance.
So the first one is transport of materials, for example, hormones, metabolic waste and nutrients. The other one is movement, like flying in insects, swimming in fish, and walking in animals. Then we go to breathing in animals and plants. The fourth one is moving of substances across the cell membrane. We have different kinds of moving, like osmosis, diffusion, and active transport. The other one is also respiration helps us in functioning of body organs such as kidney, heart, and brain. The main food material that is broken down is carbohydrates, that is glucose. And in case there is no carbohydrates, we use fatty acids and glycerols. And in case of starvation, where there is no carbohydrates and fatty acids, proteins are used, which are broken down to amino acids. My other colleague will take you to the structure of the mitochondria.
We go on to the structure of the mitochondria. Okay, in here we're being told that respiration mostly takes place in the cell organelle, which is known as the mitochondria. Okay, this is the mitochondria. This one, the outside cell is the outer membrane. Then this is the inner membrane. This is the outer membrane. This is the inner membrane. These are the projections. Then inside the inner projections, we have a fluid known as the matrix. Then we're being told that in the inner projections is also known as the crystal, and the crystal, it provides a large surface area for respiration to be able to take place. Then in the mitochondria, it's mostly used in cells which require a lot of energy, like the sperm cell, the kidney cell, the muscle cell, and the flight cell, in mostly found in insects and birds. Then we have we are being told in the mitochondria we have two membranes, that is the outer membrane and the inner membrane. We have come to the end of our discussion here on Science Hub. I have been Tiffany McKenna.
Michelle Gaboni.
Michelle Tetu.
Keep it at Elimu TV, where we watch and
learn.